Welcome. We are live in studio at the studio by Feast It Forward. I have the wonderful chef Hal Yamashita and Satoshi Tanaka. Thank you. That was a mouthful. Thank you so much for being here. And in celebratory custom here, I thought we might open some of your sake. Yes. You can tell us a little bit about.
これは僕の生まれた町で作ったお酒で。
How much do I
pour? 年に100本ぐらいしか年に1000本しか作れないです。
So this sake was actually made in the hometown where he's from in Kobe, and it's very, very limited production sake. They only make 1,000 bottles per year.
Oh, wow. 神戸ってよくお肉で有名ですけど、実はお酒もすごく有名なんです。
And Kobe, of course, as you know, is very famous for its Kobe beef.But it's also very, very famous for a Japanese sake there as well.
Cheers.
Japanese sake, kanpai.
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 Kanpai. Kanpai. Okay, we're going to get right into this. But for those of you watching live at home, please text and message all your questions on Facebook. I have our Microsoft little Surface up here. I can see everything that you're chatting about and asking and inquiring with Chef.Before we get started, what inspired you to become a chef?
まず、スタートする前にですね、どういうふうな発想ですね、インスピレーション。
お料理？
お料理に買ったんでしょうか？
小さい時、家が料理屋をやってたもんですから、あと神戸という場所でいろんな文化がミックスされてる。そこでいろんな料理にインスピレーションを受けて料理になりました。
So his family actually had a restaurant in Kobe.And so that was one of the inspiration behind it. And Kobe, as you know, is a very international town with a lot of different cultures coming in. And that also inspired him to look at outside of Japan as well to see what is out there too.
Well, we are inspired to have you here. Chef Yamashita happened to be in town and heard about the studio by Feast It Forward. He is opening a restaurant here in America in Napa Valley. We're very, very excited. So he thought...Maybe he'd do a little taste of what's to come, but on a much more casual scale, something that you too can do at home, because I know I won't be cooking anything he will be serving me at his restaurant. So I will learn from you here something simple that you can cook at home. And again, ask your questions. So what do we have?
はい。和食って多分すごく難しいイメージがあると思うんですけどね。今日はすごく簡単なものを作りたい。
People think that washoku or Japanese cuisine is very, very complicated. So what he said, well, today I want to do something that people can do this at home and enjoy it. So he made a very simple way to do that, easily, quickly, even without cooking.
よく皆さんが知ってる和食っていうのは何？寿司？天ぷら？で、これってやっぱり日本料理っていう少しちょっとレベルの高いお料理なんですね。で、それを、もっとカジュアルに、まして私のやってる新和食というスタイルの中でちょっと今日あるものだけでパパッとできるようなものをしたい。もしぜひライブだったら皆さんも家でやってみてください。
And so a lot of people think that when you say washoku or Japanese cuisine, they think of sushi, they think of tempura, but actually those are very, very high level cooking. And of course that's not something we're doing today. His restaurant is also what's called the 新和食 or the new 和食 style of cooking.Which is also a very different way of taking traditional recipes, ingredients, and making something very new and unique out of it. So that's not what we're doing. But he said, okay, well, let's see something that we can do while you're at home. So please watch online and follow me, and we'll do something that's fun.
Great.
Okay. じゃあ、まず簡単に作ります。今日はね、マグロご用意しました。
So today we have some tuna here.
よ、カットか。
And while he dives into that, because I know he's very focused, I thought I would ask about the sake. I know a good amount about wine. Is it customary to swirl sake, to volatilize the esters and bring in air, or how do you properly drink sake?
日本酒の飲み方としてですね、これはやっぱりワインみたいにこういうふうにグラスでぐるぐるぐるっと回すのが伝統的ですが、それともどういうふうな楽しみ方が一番いいんでしょうか。
本当は日本酒っていうのは小さいおちょこで少しずつ飲むのがスタイルなんですけど、最近私が作っているのはすごく華やかな香りのする日本酒を作ってます。なのでぜひ回していただいて香りを嗅いでください。もうワインとほぼ一緒ですね。はい。それではあとはこの辺で。
Traditional sake is served in very small glasses, a little bit at a time.
Not small glass.
But what Chef did is, this is an original brand, and he worked with the sake brewery for about 2 years, crafting a style that really worked with his modern cuisine. And so this is made more like in the style of wine than it is sake. So yes, please do put it in your wine glass.
It's beautiful.
Give it a nice swirl. Enjoy the aroma and really appreciate it like how you would a wine.
Oh, it's gorgeous. And so when do we anticipate opening the restaurant?
He's hoping to be open and start having some customers in by May, hopefully.
Wonderful. Very, very cool. So from a Japanese influence of the cuisine, has anything... We know so many chefs in here have been inspired by you, and we're very excited for you to come. What has inspired your influence of Japanese cuisine and coming to America, and why Napa?
いろんな質問があるんですけど、まあ、その料理の、まあ、インスピレーション、まあ、ご家族の、料理亭とかそういうような、話の中でですね、まあ、こういうふうな新和食を今度ナパに持ってくる、どういうふうなインスピレーションがあったんでしょうか。
まあ、私も今、東京とか、シンガポールにもレストランが あるんですけど、結構アメリカもいろんなところ回りました。全米各地もいろいろ行った中で、やっぱりナパっていうところはとてもこの、自然が豊かで、食材が美味しい、まあ、私たちは所詮料理人なので、美味しい食材がないと料理できないですね。その環境がまず抜群に、あと人がいい、それがもう一番の理由です。
So Chef Hals visited a lot of different places in the U.S. and said, you know, where should I open my restaurant? Well, he has a restaurant, of course, in Tokyo. He's also got a place in Singapore as well and various other places in Japan. But as a chef who really relies on cooking with good ingredients, he said, well, you know what? Napa's really got that covered. Fresh, natural ingredients all year round. And also he said, you know, he really enjoys the people here. Very relaxed, but also very sophisticated when it comes to food and wine.
Perfect.
That's what I thought you said. Okay, can I touch your knife? Am I allowed to touch your knife? Because I want to know all about this glorious knife. And was this forged just for you?
このナイフはですね、非常になんかすごい珍しい感じなんですけど、
これは
シェフのためにカスタムで作られたんですか？
そうですね、バランスとかグリップとかは全部例えばこれもそうですけど、名前が全部名前が入ってたりとか、はい。
So this is all custom made. As you can see, it has his name on the blade, and these are all well balanced and set and in terms of weight as well to what he likes.
There you go. Oh wow, yeah. I mean, this detail is just.
これは36枚の刃を重ねてこう打っていく伝統的な技法だ。
So this has 36 layers of steel that was been hand made, and I think Damascus.
Damascus.
It's called Damascus steel. It's a very very traditional way of making it.
すごくこれだから自然の模様ですからね。人がつけた模様ではなくて。
And the pattern is actually not decoration, but that's actually a natural pattern after with the actual making of the blade itself.
Wow.
でこう触ってもらったら分かるように、ちょっとザラザラしてますよね。
If you touch it, it's really, really rough.
I feel, yeah, it's like braille.
そうした時に、カットした時に素材がひっつかないです。
And that keeps the ingredients from sticking to the knife as you slice and cut them.
でも僕実はアメリカのナイフも買っちゃったんですよ。
I just heard American knife and then you laughed. What did we do wrong?
No. Actually, he said, you know, I want to share it with you though. I did buy an American knife because it was so fun.
Oh,
okay. すごくいい、すごくいいかっこいいです。ほら。
New West knife works.
So. Okay. USA.
Yeah? USA.
Really, it's a local knife store here in Napa.
Napa
ですよね。
Napa.
Okay.
Yeah, but he really liked the way it felt in his hand.
特にこう日本のシェフはこういう、こう刃物に対して特別な思いがすごくあるので、やっぱり自分の道具はすごく大事にしますね。
And Japanese chefs in particular do a lot of slicing, a lot of cutting、with different, very specific knives. And so they carry a lot of different knives, they take good care of them, and it's a lifelong friend, if you will, for
sure.
them.
Important, very important.
ちょっとお話ししてるうちに、マグロをカットして、ここに醤油を入れました。
And so while we were talking, he sliced up into cubes of the tuna and put a little bit of soy sauce.
で、ガーリックですね。少し。
and take a little plain and a little bit of garlic minced in there.
でこれニンニクでも生姜でもジンジャーでも大丈夫です。
And you can do garlic. If you don't want to use garlic, you put ginger. You can do both.
あとそう。ちょっとこれを言っておきたいのは、お醤油ってすごく実はデリケートなソースなんですね。だからもし保管するときは冷蔵庫でお願いしたいです。
And one little tip for the listeners out there, he said, soy sauce is actually a very delicate sauce, very, very sensitive. So when you, once you open it, please put it in the refrigerator, and so it'll last longer and stay fresher.
これは結構世界中でも言ってるんですね。
And he keeps telling his customers all over the place and all over the world, watch out, you know, sauce is very, very, it's a living sauce, and take care of it.
はい。で、これを約20分ぐらいつけたらこういうふうに色が変わります。
And once you marinate the tuna after about 20 minutes, it'll be look what it looked like on the right hand side.
これ色が悪いわけじゃないですからね。で、これを。
I also found it very interesting for those of you not in studio here. When I came up and I saw the avocados sitting on the counter and I grabbed it and I was like, oh, it's hot. It was very, very hot. And what were you doing that for?You put this in the oven.
今日スタジオに来た時にアボカドが表に置いてあったですね。これ触ってみたらすごい熱かったんですけど、何なんですか？
はいはい。普通のアボカドね、このちょっと私がアボカド触った時に硬かった、すごくまだ売れてない状態。
So when he first came here and looked at the avocado and he touched, he said this is really really hard and not quite ripe.
はい。アボカドクリームみたいなこう味が欲しかったので、実は180度のオーブンで約10分ほど焼きました。
And so what he did was he put the avocado in the oven and roasted it at 180 degrees Celsius to get it that nice creamy texture.
So I'm assuming he's done that before. That's not a first.
そうすると、もうすごく綺麗に、ほら。
Oh, wow.
And he said, notice how it's very, very soft, almost creamy texture.
ちょっと焼くだけでこんなんなんです。
Just from roasting just a little bit of time.
これちょっと便利ですよ。
It's a good tip to know.
ボールが欲しいね。
ミキシング
ボール。OK。で、これもすごく簡単。もうアボカド入れちゃいます。
And so he's going to put some avocado into the bowl.
And we will put the list of ingredients and items on the stream here. So when people are done and want to make this at home, you have the menu.So ingredients, very important to you, very fresh, important to source the best.
食材がやはり非常にこの料理する中で重要視しているものですね。
そうですね。本当に美味しくないものを料理しても美味しくならないので。
He said you can't take bag ingredients and make something good out of it. So you have to have, you start with something really, really good and that's how you end up with good food.
使う調味料もそんなにたくさん使えません。私の場合はとてもアウトプットシンプルに作るんで、素材にやっぱりその持ってる力がすごく大事なので。
And the chef said that it's not about using a lot of different spices and sauces. It's about keeping things very, very simple. Having the output also come very, very simple, but really relying on the quality ingredient to deliver the flavor.
The salmon is beautiful.
あとはこれスモークサーモンです。
And he's slicing the smoked salmon.
これあんまりこう日本では複数の魚を混ぜることはないんですけど、こうやってこういろんなこう混ぜることによってこう料理の味が奥行きが出てきますね。
In traditional Japanese cooking and in Japan in general, you don't really mix two different types of fish. But by doing so, he feels that you get a much deeper layer of flavor this way.
この時その美味しくしようと思うと色の近い魚を合わせてあげてください。白い系であれば白系、赤系であれば赤系。
But one hint is that if you are going to use two different types, try to make sure that the color is somewhat in the neighborhood. If you're going to use white looking fish, try to stick with that kind of color. Darker colors are darker colors.
で、わさびを少し。
A little bit of wasabi.
これお好みで。あと、ちょっとわさびだけだとどうしてもアボカドのクリームさでわさびの香りがなくなるので少しチリを入れます。
And if it's wasabi by itself, avocado actually might overpower it and make the wasabi go away. So he's adding a little bit of the chili sauce there.
このチリもあまり入れすぎないでくださいね。
And not too much chili sauce.
で、レッドオニオンですね、これ。
And minced red onions.
これはすごくこう、 テイストが強いので、カットしてから水に3回ぐらいつけてます。
And just to take out that strong, spiciness of the onion, he's, soaked the onion about three times and washed it, carefully just to make it more mild.
で、これがダブルクリームですね。
And it's got double cream there.
And you can get all of these ingredients at Whole Foods. So besides the shisho leaf, which I am very curious about and understanding that ingredient, everything else you can actually get at the grocery store.
これあのご存知ですか？これは。
So yes.
Do people know what this is?
I do not.
わかりません。
大葉。
It's called 大葉。
シソリーフですね。
Or shiso leaf.
これはあのよくお刺身とかに行った時にこう飾りで。つけてあったりとか巻物の中に入ってたりするんですけど、日本のあのとてもクラシックな、ハーブですよね。
A lot of times, when you order a sashimi, you might see this as a decoration, or they might roll it into the roll itself. It's considered a very, traditional and oftentimes used, herb for Japanese cooking.
Okay.
で、刺身についてる大葉とか例えばわさびって実は意味があってですね。これは、一つは、まず消毒をする効果があります。
So there's actually some significance as to why they use these herbs. First reason is, for disinfecting, I think, or keeping, the food safe and healthy.
Oh, interesting.
でもう一個は、精神をこうリラックスさせる効果があるので。
Like a digestive.
No, actually, he said it actually helps relax, your spirit. Yes.
Oh, Zen.
It's a relaxing kind of herb.
でもこれ香りもすごくいいんですよ。香りよかったら。
Ooh, can I try? Yeah. There's a little lemon verbena.
そうそうそうそう。
Lemon verbena みたいな感じ。
レモンのような感じの、あとちょっとこうなんだろう、ミントみたいな感じ。
Oh, wow. Absolutely.
すごくこう爽やかな味がします。
Very refreshing.
で、これはあの鉄のものを好まないので。
I feel very relaxed.
できれば。そうそうそう。
And apparently the shiso leaf reacts to steel, so he said, please use your hand, don't use your knife if you can.
Chef, what would you call your style of cooking? And I'm understanding you taking what you've learned and merging your style into that in the Japanese culture, but how would you explain your specific type of cooking?
Chef の料理のスタイルはどういうスタイルっていうふうに説明したらいいでしょうか？
新和食っていう言い方をしていて、和食と和食をミックスしたフュージョンですね。
And so he's calling this, Shin Washoku. Shin basically means new. And so like in the French would be a nouvelle cuisine, in a way. So what he's done is taken traditional Japanese, cooking and preparation methodology, combined that with some very new modern way of preparing things, still using the same ingredient, but coming out with a very different result.
So when you are not cooking, what is your comfort food? What is your binge food to hang out and just relax and not cook?
料理しないときにですね、本当にあの、まあ、簡単になんか食べたいようなとか、どういうふうなものが好みでしょうか?
I saw him eating a big hamburger today. He's like, oh, this is so good.
あの、皆さんと一緒でハンバーガーのような僕らのソウルフードというと、おにぎりかもわかんない。おにぎりかもわかんない。ソウルフードだよね。
So he's calling it soul food, but it's called onigiri. Onigiri is actually a term that means to grip. It's what we call a rice ball.
Okay.
So you take a little bit of rice, you put something in the middle, you turn it into a little triangular, ball, and you can put, some seaweed around it. It's something that, kids take to, picnics, to school lunches. It's a very traditional, meal. Very easy to pack, easy to carry.
Very cool. That looks delicious. And these, which I know he will speak of in a moment, these beautiful rice crackers.
Rice cracker.
And I'm assuming that this is going to be the kind of plate for your dish.
これはあのもともと、それこそ今から、400年、500年ほど前ぐらいからある和菓子の、材料です。で、モナカというもので、もち米から作ってますね。で、これは普段、日本では結構スイーツに使われるんですけど、それを私はあの料理に使います。
So this is called Monaka. It's spelled M-O-N-A-K-A. And it's made from, glutinous rice. You turn that into powder. and this is almost like a cracker or like a little bit more like a wafers. And typically these are used for sweets. So you would take the monaka and you fill it with sweet bean paste or other kind of bean paste, and it's usually served as sweets or dessert. But the chefs use this as a way to make different servings.
でちょっとあのなんていうか表面が湿気てるから少しオーブンで少しだけ温めます。
And so what the chef is doing is he's actually warming up the,、the wafers a little bit so it gets a little bit more crunchy、and、drying that out a little bit in the oven right now.
So what are you most excited about to opening your restaurant here? Because you have a very big support and fan base system obviously in Japan, but coming to America, we got your little baggies.
アメリカでオープンするにあたってどういうふうな期待とか、感動ありますかね
Besides the wine. Besides the wine.
ワイン以外に。ワイン以外に。いや、ナパで。
ナパでオープンするにあたって。
やはりあの、今私は、日本にレストランだけで、春山市のスタイルだけで5軒あります。そこにやっぱ毎日多くの日本の方も来るし、世界中からお客さんいらっしゃいますよね。そのスタイルを可能な限りナパで持ってきて、一つ違うのは、ナパの食材で、
So he has about 5 locations in Japan right now. A lot of guests from Japan as well as from international countries overseas. And so people are used to that kind of a style, but he wants to create the same cooking but using the ingredients from Napa, a local ingredients, and to see what that would look like.
And so what can we expect? What is the menu? What does it range from as far as small bites to your beautiful dishes? I mean...I looked at his website, and these are like picture-perfect moments on a plate. It was extraordinary. So I, myself, as an Instagrammer, will take many a pictures of those. But from a menu standpoint, are there a couple items that you can kind of tell the guests?
まだメニュー構成は大人かもしれませんけど、はい、まあ、どういうふうな感じの、料理が出てくるんでしょうかね。
まあ、すき焼きと、あと一番メインにしたいのが、ロバターってご存知ですか、日本のとってもクラシック日本ってこうロバタって火の料理フランスはオーブンの料理逆に日本は火の料理なので炎を使ったお料理でお肉を焼いたり魚を焼いたりとかっていうものをちょっと結構メインに置きたいと思ってます
So he's going to have something traditional like sukiyaki but the main draw is going to be the Robata grill and Robata is a way of cooking with charcoal fuel and so it's not quite barbecue but it's really grilling over fireBe it fish, be it meat, be it vegetables, taking something fresh of the season that's local and preparing it very simply over fire.
Wonderful.
野菜をこうパッと炭火で焼いたものに、味噌と味噌のソースであったりとかそういうものをしたいです。
And something as simple as like a little miso sauce that, of course, if a chef is making, it's going to probably be very, very delicious and complicated. But yeah, that's what he's going to have.
20 ingredient miso.
Exactly, 20 ingredients, yes.
和食はやっぱり最も大事なことはまず体にいいこと。今食べてもやっぱりそれこそ10年後の自分のためにってよく僕らは言うんですけどそういうのを心がけて体にいいことをやっぱりどんどんナパで広げていきたい
and washoku and as you may all know it's very healthy food and he wants to carry on that health message as well eat something very healthy something fresh something seasonal and take care of your body you know even 10 years into the future
言ってる焼けましたね
said the wafers and the cracker must be ready the monaka should be ready by now
In regard to Kobe, is that how you pronounce Kobe?
Okay.
多分さっきと違うちょっと割ってみてください。
は
い。
Oh! Snap it, see how?
Wow, yeah.
Yep, crispy and different texture.
Mm-hmm. Very different. It actually disintegrates much quicker.
Mm-hmm. で、口当たりも非常に美味しいし。
そう
です。So your hometown of Kobe, and this is a big influence, obviously, from a Kobe beef standpoint in your restaurants.For the novice watching this, what is the difference between your standard cut and of beef to Kobe?
あの神戸もちろん出身が神戸っていうことで、まあ、神戸牛アメリカ人に非常に有名で、はい、皆さん知ってる、まあ、牛肉なんですけど、神戸牛和牛とですね、まあ、一般的な牛肉どういうふうに違うんでしょうか？
一般的な牛肉というのは日本の牛肉なんでしょうか、アメリカの牛肉なんでしょうか
？So, beef in the U.S. or beef in Japan? So comparing it to more of the local.
I mean, I guess what? Yeah, the local ingredient. They're probably completely different.
もう少しアメリカの牛肉、特にここのお客さんたちが、まあ視聴者の方たちが、まあ相手にしている中で、
どうですか？あ、そうですか。あの、日本のやっぱり和牛ってもちろんご存知ですけど、あの水がいい良くないとダメなんですね。 お酒もできますけど、牛は日本の牛は1日だいたい水を60リットル飲みます。で、気候が良くて水がいいところで、そこで、すごくこうリラックスした環境の中で、穀物を食べて牛は育つんですね。で、日本の牛は本当に毎日ブラッシングをされて音楽を聴いてそれがやっぱりすごくこう、そしてこう生産者たちもこう日々美味しく作るようにどんどんどんどんこう、グレードというものを上げていっているので、はい、まさにあれは芸術品ですね。
So one thing I haven't heard before is that he said the water is really really important. So having some really really clean drinking water for cows. Apparently they drink about 60 liters per head per day.
Wow.
And Kobe is also famous for its mineral water. Rokko
の水。Rokko の水、そうです。
There's a water from a mountain range called Rokko, which is very very famous. It's bottled and sold throughout Japan. And so he said that is one of the important things about keeping the cows healthy when well hydrated.Of course, they're fed really good grains, and so that's what they eat. And of course, you may have heard some of the other stories, like listening to Mozart, listening to music, they get massaged, they get brushed every day, and so it's really living a stress-free life, and that's what makes the Kobe beef so unique.
Very cool.
できました。言ってる前できちゃったけど。どうする？いいの？
And as we're talking, it is all ready. To,
I love this.
Enjoy.
I love that this little beautiful snack.
Yeah,
do I get one?
Snack.
It, well, at home, I'm going to make this. I'm just going to put some in my purse and leave. May I? Right? It's beautiful.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. The crunch, it's beautiful. Thank you. Clean, fresh, nice amount of spice, not too spicy. Good spice.
でもこれ中に刺身が入ってますからね。
It's basically sashimi inside.
Mm-hmm. Wonderful. All right, before we head out, and again, last questions, we'll have all of the recipes on here for you to make this at home, the casual Hal Yamashita. This. Chef came yesterday to check out the...location and he gifted us with these beautiful little jars. I had no idea what this was and opened it up and tasted it and it blew my mind. And there is 20 little ingredients in this beautiful, beautiful package. That will you be selling these at the restaurant?
いやこれどう売るかなどうかなこれね魔法のレシピなので。
He's like that's too much work.
He said it's magical recipe. So I'm not sure that we'll be selling it.
No, to purchase for people to cook at home.
Maybe not, he said. Okay, has to think about it.
All right, but what's in here? What is this glorious mix?
これ旨味って知ってますか皆さん。
So do people know what umami is?
でこれを最後に少しかけると。
And just a little finishing touch there at the end. So umami will translate roughly to savoriness in English. It's considered the fifth taste on your taste buds. So you heard about sweet, sour, salty, bitter, and umami is considered the fifth taste.
これには椎茸の干したもの、干し貝柱、それから山椒。
椎茸、干し貝柱、山椒。So the first three is mushroom.
Japanese mushroom.
Japanese mushroom. Shiitake mushroom.
Shiitake mushroom.
And then dried clams.
Dried clams.
Clams, yes.
And then sansho is a type of Japanese pepper.
Pepper. あと yuzu.
And yuzu.
それから、みかんの皮とかシトラスの皮。
And mikan is a Japanese satsuma rind.
So good.
それから、2つの、島で取れた塩。
And two different kinds of salt from different islands in Japan. And some nori, which is Japanese seaweed.
それも本当にプレミアムな四国の一部しか取れない青のりが使ってます。
And it's not just any nori from the grocery store. It's from Shikoku, which is the southern part of Japan, on a particular island. They get this raw, 青のり is like a raw seaweed that they get.And dried.
だから、あとは昆布が3種類。
And three different kinds of kombu. Kombu is a thicker kind of kelp that is oftentimes used for making stock, dashi stock for umami flavor.
それを、全部、もっと他にもいろいろちょっと入っているんで、シークレットレシピが入っているんですけど、オールナチュラルなものだけで20種類。
And then there's a few other things that are hidden secret recipes, but there are about 20 different things in that salt mixture there.
なのですごくこう、味が柔らかいので、結構アメリカのスパイスって最初に塗ってから焼きませんか。これは逆に塗って焼いちゃうと香りが飛んじゃうので、焼き上がってから塗って食べるような感じです。
And so unlike rich regular salt, one of the nice thing about it is the aromatics, if you like to smell this. And so he said, please, you know, when you have a very good aromatic salt like this, you use it as a finishing salt, not before you cook. Because once you cook it and heat it, the aroma goes away.
Got it. Like a finishing oil on a salad.
Finishing oil みたいな感じですね。
完璧です。
Well, Chef, thank you.
Thank you very much.
We're very excited for you to open the restaurant. And it is here in downtown Napa on Main Street. Chef Hal Yamashita, we look forward to eating lots of your food. And I will put this on my breakfast in the morning. All right. Tune in next time. Thanks so much. Visit us at the studio by Feast of Forward. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. So, so yummy.
Thank you very much.